It's time for another LEGO contest, and that means it's time for me to enter another model from the Nickel Plate Road. For this year's Brick Train Awards, my entry is 70130, a composite gondola. This unique hybrid design of steel and wood was a product of the Nickel Plate Road's 1923 acquisition plan, which saw the construction of 500 composite gondolas. The high cost of steel deterred the growing railroad from an all-steel-designed gondola, opting instead to use wooden frames and floors on an all-steel frame built by the Standard Steel Car Company. They were effectively flat cars with short wooden sides and Murphy drop doors on the ends on a wooden floor. These gondolas quietly entered service at the end of 1923 and were used in freight service through the 1960s when the Nickel Plate Road became the Norfolk and Western. Reclassified as G34s, these gondolas lasted all the way until 1984 in N&W work train service, all still lettered for the Nickel Plate Road. The sole survivor of the class is 70130, which was donated to the Mad River and Nickel Plate Road Railroad Museum in Bellevue, Ohio. This was a natural fit for which road number to design, as the design process was a combination of scaling actual diagrams to 8-wide L-gauge and eyeballing the prototype. Now, the frame does share a similar bone structure to the brick model railroader flat car, but it greatly differs to achieve the shape of the car. The supports on the side scale out to 8-wide, meaning the wooden planks on the inside are 7-wide in the majority of places. 1x2 stud jumpers help fill in the illusion of wooden planks underneath. Speaking of underneath, this car features an accurate reproduction of the New York Brake Company's Triple K brake valve and rigging. I was able to find diagrams online of the correct brake arrangement, compared that to some of my AccuRail cars that I have from the same time period to make sure I have it right. I was so confident in this design that I was shocked when I went under the real gondola to find it had been swapped to a modern Westinghouse design at some point in its career. Oh well, I like the original version better. Now, as you may have noticed, my model does lack any decals, and this was done intentionally. I want to reflect how the car currently looks and raise awareness about the museum. Every time I visit the Mad River and Nickel Plate Road Railroad Museum, I notice something new, something updated, or something cleaned up, and a lot of their equipment is currently being repainted and in need of lettering. If you want to help them out, click the link in the description to donate to the museum. Any big or small donation helps. All things considered, this model came together from an idea to a physical build in the entire month of September, and I am very satisfied with the results. Freight cars are not the most glamorous items in the railroad, but they are still important. Given that the Nickel Plate Road had a lot of unique items of rolling stock, I have no shortage of inspiration for future projects. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to help out the museum, I've got a link in the description. Until then, see you next time for the next LEGO build.